It's time for the Family Feud, introducing the Gould family. Doug, MJ, Piper, Mark, and Kerry, ready for action. And the Kleftogiannis family. Chula, Angela, Julie, Georgia, and Joanna. On your marks, let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
I swear to you, no, I swear, on my life, I have not looked at Carrie's answer. In case she didn't see the show, I wrote her a poem, and the poem was trying to get her to go out with me, and gave her a little thing. She could say yes or no. I have not looked. How many people, before I look, think that she will mark no? Just applaud if you're... I'm depressed already. How many people think wrote yes? Well, that's cheered me up. But I'm frightened to look. Well, no, because if it's a no after that big... No. Let me just meet both the families. I'll look before we go to one of the commercials. I hope all the yeses were right, though. They're our champs right here, the Goulds. Make them feel it. You are the champs now. You got money. How much you win?
I'm in a dream. I can't believe it.
You got how much?
Don't pinch me. I'll wake up. $6,810.
Yeah. Well done. Well done. You had a winning duo up there. It did very well. Let's meet everybody, please.
This is my wonderful wife, MJ.
Hi, sweetie pie.
My daughter, Piper.
Hi, Richard.
Hi, Piper.
Her husband, Mark.
Hi, Richard.
And Carrie, my daughter.
Hello.
Well, I want to make sure it's still there. Piper, for someone who was a little unsure about whether you should go up there for fast money, scored 174 on your own. Sensational. Truly.
Thank you.
Godfrey, Daniel. Lefty Golfy Clubly. Some very pretty lady. How do I say your name?
Kleftogiannis.
Kleftogiannis.
That's right.
That's a hard name, honey. How are
you doing?
Say it for me again.
Kleftogiannis.
Kleftogiannis.
Yes.
Piece of cake. How do I say your first name?
Tula.
Oh, Tula. Tula, Tula. Can I meet your family, please?
Yes, this is my lovely sister, Angela.
Hi, Hello, Richard.
Angela. My sister-in-law, Julie.
Hi.
Hi, Julie.
My sister, Georgia.
Hi, Richard.
Hello, Georgia.
And my older sister, Joanna.
Nice. Hello, Richard. Nice to have you here, darling. Oh, is that a Greek name?
Yes, it's Greek.
A Greek name. Were any of you born in Greece, or did you just have...
Four of us.
We were all born in Greece, yes. We've been here for 13 years, and we now adopted my sister-in-law, Julie. She's also baptized Greek and everything like that.
Oh, did you all come over together?
Yes,
that's right.
Mm-hmm.
Just a big group of you, mom and dad. And
Mama and papa. And
everybody?
Everybody.
Where do you live, all of you?
In Kalamata.
That's okay.
Where the hell is Kalamata? No, I mean here. Where do you live here?
Oh, here. Oh, my gosh.
My heart stopped.
We live in Canoga Park.
Canoga Park, I understand. I thought you were going back to Greece every night. Canoga Park.
Yes, yes.
Come on, we're going to play the feud. Let's go. People survey, top five answers on the board. You got to try and find the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name a famous trophy or award.
Yeah. Then me.
Emma. Alrighty, four answers will beat it.
The Heisman.
Heisman? Yeah.
We're going to play.
All right, that's football, huh?
Yes.
All right, little angel. Well done, you. They had to drag this guy on, you know, this all these... Truly. This is the truth. I found this out. He did not want to come on the show. He's now giving me number one answers. You're very good.
I'm in that dream.
I'm proud of you. Very proud of you. famous trophy or award?
Well, I have got to say the Oscar, or Academy Award.
Okay. Good answer. The Oscar? Well done. Named after the wiener, if I recall. Hello.
Hello.
You're looking a bit dapper here today. Very nice. What's in a famous trophy or an award?
How about a gold medal in the Olympics?
Okay.
Good.
The Olympic medal? Don't look so glum. Mark, how you doing?
Good.
Let's see. What have you got there for me?
How about the Nobel Peace Prize?
Good answer.
Okay, Nobel Peace Prize? Yeah. I forgot all about you know at the end of that show. I'm going to look today, though.
Okay.
The famous trophy or award?
How about the Pulitzer?
Oh, yeah. Pulitzer Prize? No. $76. Dula, come on, my darling. Two answers left and you can get it.
The Loving Cup. Richard, we couldn't think of any. We'd have to go with the Loving Cup.
It's probably a Greek award we know nothing about. Well, take a look. If the Loving Cup say you get the $76, but as a banker, Doug, I think you must feel very secure at this moment. Loving Cup? Great. Is that hockey? Right? Four? You know what that is, don't you?
Yeah.
Anyone who can do Sammy Davis. Back right after that. Yeah. Six, nothing. Let's go.
Hi, good luck.
How are you doing?
Fine.
Nice to see you.
We brought something for you. We forgot to give it to you.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, these are called worried bits. Worried you don't bits. Have any worries. We know that.
It's quite nice. You're not worried at all, are you?
I don't know.
Now, can you eat these if you have a headache?
Only if you're very, very hungry.
Only if you're very hungry?
Yes.
You're a sweetheart. Thank you. Thank you all, darlings. Thank you. 100 people surveyed. Top six answers on the board is the question. Name something people use for transportation in Alaska. Yes.
The dogs.
The dogs.
Good answer.
Okay. What are you going to do?
Good play, Richard.
Good play, my darling. Very good. I'm very proud of you, Andrew.
Hi, Gary. Hi.
What do people use in Alaska for transportation? Does this make me look too show busy?
You look cute.
I was saying to Rod Stewart the other day, Rod, I said... what do people use?
Skis?
Let's take a look.
That's right.
Skis?
Yes, yes,
oh. Well, I don't think it's right. I think it was a good answer. Hello. Georgia, my doll? Beats having your ears pierced, doesn't it? What do people use for transportation in Alaska?
They use canoes.
Take a look.
Yeah.
Fishing.
Yes.
Fishing.
Yeah. Home kayak. We're delighted you're here. Now, can you give me a goodie?
I'll say their feet.
Their feet.
They walk.
Okay. Get it out. Feet. No, not that. Well, my darling, 1, 2, 3, 4 answers left. But two strikes up there.
I would have to say a truck, four-wheel drive, or a Jeep, something
okay,
like that.
Okay, let's take a look.
Good answer, that's right.
Is there all right if not third strike? A truck? Wow! Well done, well done.
Hi, Richard. She stole my answer.
Yeah.
But I'll think of something else.
Okay.
About their animals, some kind of donkey, like we do in Greece, a horse, or whatever they have there.
Whatever the animal native to that area is, all right?
I don't know the answer.
An Alaskan animal. No, not that. $76?
Snowmobile. No, airplane or snowmobile?
Give me an answer, Doug.
We're going to go with airplane.
Airplane. If it's that, I got it all. If not, dead even game. Airplane. You got it. Two. Snowmobile. Six. Snowmobile. Yeah, they're not like skis, darling. There's those funny big things, yeah. You know. Look like tennis rackets. In fact, I think they are. But I know. We do nothing. Let's go. Yeah. 100 people surveyed, top six answers on the board. Here is the question. Name a physical characteristic of the devil.
Yeah. Horns.
Horn. Very good.
Okay, we'll play.
Greek dissension. We'll play. Yes.
No. A Trojan horse.
Were you the no vote?
Yes.
Well, this is not hard. The devil.
Tail.
That's right.
Tail. Very good. Very good. This can be a bit dangerous, can't they, in a confined space?
Sometimes, yes.
Yeah. Flog yourself to death. What do we know about the devil?
The head.
The what now?
The head.
The head, his
right.
head?
Yes.
Okay.
Good answer, that's my head.
His head. Not that. A physical characteristic of the devil, too.
Okay, doesn't he carry a thing, like a fork?
Yeah, he does.
What is that called?
Fork.
A fork. Good, that's what I said.
Pitchfork.
Pitchfork, yeah. Right.
He used to pitch, as a matter of fact. Pitchfork. Not bad. Angel, he does. He prods you all the time, the rascal. Come on, little one.
The way, the clothes, the way he's dressed, black or...
His clothes?
You know what I mean. Yeah, all his right. clothes.
Okay,
yeah.
His appearance.
Gotcha. If his clothes, they're all right. If not, third strike. His clothes?
Oh, no. No.
$83.
Oh, boy.
Company gang, we're not confident at all.
Physical characteristic of the devil.
We're going to hope he has a goatee.
All righty. If it's there, big lead for you. If not, Doodle gets the $83. Goatee. Number three. Four.
Nice.
Describing Gene now. Six. Pointed ear. 235, still nothing. Let's go. Doll values are doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Tell me something a woman would complain to her butcher about. Yes.
The meat's too tough.
Too tough meat. Two answers will beat it, Mark.
Too small a cut.
Too small a cut. You got it? What are you going to do? Play or pass?
We play,
Richard.
We play.
All right. Very proud of you.
Yes, we play.
What would a woman complain to her butcher about?
That the meat was spoiled.
Spoiled.
Okay. Yes. Yeah.
Spoiled meat. Yeah.
How about that?
You were lovely. Get right in the game now.
Okay, how about... having too much fat, not trimming
yeah,
it.
Like that.
Yes, yes,
too
yes,
fat. Yes. Good, darling. No strikes, one answer left.
I'll probably do it again, but
no.
How about the prizes, Richard?
Good, oh, I like it.
Right, yeah.
It costs too much. Now we got a game. 235, 188. Let's go. Come on, Angel. That reminds me, I've not looked at my note. I'll put it here so that I do it before anything else. This will decide it. Dollar values are tripled. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something people put plugs in.
Yeah. On the wall.
On the wall?
We're going to play.
We're going to play. Honey, I'm proud of you. Listen carefully, because when I get to you now, I can't repeat this. This is the fifth question. It's very easy. Name something people put plugs in. When I get to you, you've got 3 seconds. Do it.
Something people put plugs in.
Got 3 seconds.
How about in the car? The lighter that plugs into...
Okay. Cigarette lighter in the car. Now that...
Richard, I believe you put plugs in your ears.
Yeah, no, ears? Yeah. 3 seconds.
In the bathtub.
In the bathtub.
Bathtub, right on the buzzer. She did it. Bathtub?
Come on. All right.
3 seconds, Georgia.
I'll pass.
Pardon?
I'll pass.
You pass, all right. One answer left, but 2 strikes.
I'll say the bedroom. No?
Now, all electrical plugs are already up there. Okay. Don't give me any more electrical plugs. Come on. You beat the kid, huh? Oh. Well, you still may be. We'll find out. Doug, there's one answer left. If you're right, nose you're plug. The champ. If not, what do you say?
We're going to go with nose plugs.
Nose plugs, all right. If it's there, you keep your title. If not, you're the champs. Nose plug. I have a feeling it's a spark plug.
We had that. We thought of it, but we...
I mean, that's what I think, a spark plug. I don't know. 4? No, she said the car lighter for the thing.
Uh-huh.
You got it anyway. $235 plus $6,810. You had a good time, didn't you?
Yeah. Right. We enjoyed it so much. Thank you.
I'm going to read it at the end of the show. All right? I'll do it at the end of the show. Thank you. Who'll play? Who's playing? Angela, Julie, going for the money. All right, can we watch this?
You hold that for me.
No, that's my note from Carrie.
I didn't open it. Richard.
No, no, just hold on tight. We'll see if it bring you luck, okay?
Wait a minute. Whose note is this?
Well, Carrie gave it for
me.
Why
am I holding it?
I want to see if it brings you luck. Won money, and I'm just trying to give you something good for life. And 15 seconds for Angela. Name something kids do and hope that they don't get caught.
Pass.
A reason for a family reunion.
Christmas.
The age when you first fell in love.
18.
A city in Canada.
Pass.
Say, give me an answer. City in Canada.
Montreal,
she said. Turn around.
Is that Canada?
Yeah, that's Canada.
Oh, Richard, I'm so nervous.
Don't be nervous. Now you're the champs. If you don't win this time, you're still the champs. When next right. time we play, what do kids do and hope that they don't get caught? You said they try to pass. And the survey said, boom. Reason for a family reunion, you said? Christmas, survey said. There you go.
Well.
The age when you first fell in love, you said 18. Survey said... 6.
Oh,
city in Canada. Montreal. Survey said. There you go.
Yes.
We never even got to this. A good pet for an apartment, but we ran out of time. I'll take the car back. Off you go. Off you go. And we're going to take a look now for Julie. Come on, Julie. Give
thank
you a big kiss. Wish you luck. Please remind everyone the answers Angela gave us. 20 seconds on the clock, please. Name something kids do and hope that they don't get caught.
Steal something.
A reason for a family reunion.
A birthday.
The age when you first fell in love.
16.
A city in Canada.
Pass.
A good pet for an apartment.
A bird.
A city in Canada.
Oh, I can't think.
Okay. All right. that. We're making worry beads up there.
We need them.
Something kids do, and hope they don't get caught. You said steal something. Smoke cigarettes was the number one answer. Steal, the survey said. There you go. Reasonable family reunion. You said birthday, survey said. 8. A wedding. Number one answer, wedding. The age when you first fell in love. You said 16. It was number one. Survey said. 21. City in Canada, Montreal was the number one answer. You passed on that. There's not up there, you know. Toronto.
Toronto, I couldn't think.
Good pet for an apartment. You said a bird. It was number one. Survey said. There you go. 143, $5 for every point. Total of 750.
And it's just a game.
Boinky, boinky, boinky. Bye-bye. We'll see you here on the show.
Some departing contestants receive the Everything You Can Be with Mary Kay Cosmetics. Skincare and Glamour Cosmetics presented to you in your own home by trained beauty consultants, Mary Kay Cosmetics, Dallas, Texas. Make someone happy with Betty Crocker's cream cheese and nut frosting mix. Real nuts and delicious cream cheese taste for a special frosting treat. If you want your teeth their whitest, you need Pepsodent. Its low abrasion formula really does get teeth their whitest. Pepsodent toothpaste. The Popcorn Now, continuous corn popper from Presto. Uses hot air, not hot oil to pop corn. Features automatic buttering and continuous popping. This is Gene Woods speaking for Family Feud. A Mark Goodson, Bill Putnam Productions.